Devon Larratt is going to face the Bulgarian Yordan Sonev in just 4 hours' time from now. Self-admittedly, out of the two times that they have practiced together on the left arm, Devon has never been able to beat Yordan. Is the trend going to continue in the super match as well? Devon thinks otherwise. Devon has said publicly that he didn't even train for this match and he's still going to beat Yordan Sonev. Is that going to be the case? I don't think this match is completely one-sided. I think it is going to be a war either way, whoever wins, and the event is going to be amazing. Be Strong 4, Umesh Dhruvas is presenting us an amazing, amazing super match event. There are going to be 4 super matches, $7 pay-per-view, link will be in the description. So let's talk about the first match. The first match is going to be between Sandris Sedis and Yordan Sonev on the right arm. Last time, Yordan Sonev had an easy day. He beat Mike Gould 6-0 on the left. He beat Matt Mask 6-0 on the right. I'm talking about Be Strong 3 event. This time, it's the exact opposite case. He has the current WAF world champion at 110 kilos on the right arm. That's going to be opening match of the night. And that is going to be a bad day for Yordan, whether he wins or loses. Really, really difficult day. Not bad. I shouldn't say bad because it will be probably the best experience in his life. But he's going to have a tough time for sure. I have Sandris Sedis as a favorite in this match. I think that match is also a war. I don't think either one can pin the other without any problem or quickly. We saw how Yordan kind of struggled against Toddzilla Todd Hutchings inside a hook. Right now he's bigger and Sandris, I don't think he has the inside hook power that Todd Hutchings has. So this match will be amazing. Sandris may be looking for a top role. Yordan has only one move. He hooks. That's about it. And after that, there will be 2 matches. First one, I think, is going to be on the left arm. It is between Brendan Elsesser and Plamen Dimitrov. So another WAF world champion against Brendan Elsesser. Plamen is about 90 kilos. Maybe he gained some weight for this match, but I don't think he has ever been above 95. So he looks somewhere in that range, 90, 92, 3 kilo weight. And his opponent, Brendan Elsesser, I assume that he's going to be around 100 kilos. And I believe that that weight gap is kind of necessary. It is necessary to make this match competitive. Plamen Dimitrov is a pure top roller. Brendan Elsesser can do a few things. I think he can try to top roll. He can flop press as well. He can hook as well. But the question is either one of these moves that he has good enough to beat the Bulgarian world champion? Once again, have to go with Plamen Dimitrov, but I think this match is also going to be amazing. This time, people are traveling from over there to this side of the world. Devon also mentioned that they will not be feeling as good as they are used to when they compete in the European countries, because this time there will be some jet lag and they're traveling. But good to see that Devon is already giving excuses for their performance. Usually people give excuse for their own performance, but Devon is giving excuse for their performance. Looks like he knows he's going to win. Left arm, I don't know which arm is stronger for both of these, but I'm going to go with the safe bet on both arms. Let's say 4-2, Plamen Dimitrov, both left and right. And I have no idea. I wouldn't be shocked 1%. If Brendan Elsesser beats Plamen, let's say on the left arm. On the right, I think, yeah, it will be a little bit surprise, but nothing shocking. So final match, the main event, Yordan Sonev versus Devon Larratt. Left arm this time. Devon's left is not his right. We already know that. And some people think that it is about his strength only. But no, it is about his endurance as well. Devon has mentioned multiple times in the past that right now, since he started his giant pumpkin training, he doesn't get tired on the right on the table. And yet we saw him getting gassed out against Gennady. But on the left arm, he says that he gets tired. About 1 hour arm wrestling workout on the table is sufficient for his left, even against lower caliber guys. But on the right arm, he can go for the entire day. So that's how much of a difference there is between Devon's left and his right. And I'm talking about only endurance, not strength yet. And there is a strength gap as well. So I wouldn't be shocked if all of the rounds against Yordan Sonev are competitive. We saw against Sandris Sedis at Arm Wars that round 1 and round 4, 5, 6 all kind of looked close. In the beginning, in the middle, Devon started to dominate a little bit, but then I think he injured his left arm a little bit, and Sandris gained the momentum back a little bit. So Devon's endurance on the left can be manageable, but I don't think Jordan has a flop press. Sandris Sedis had that press and he kept Devon in a defensive king's move all the way. Jordan can also do that in first couple of rounds. I think he's going to pin Devon for sure. I think that's coming. And Sandris, man, you forced Jordan to cut weight to 110 kilos. He was like 113, 14 kilos anyways. Now because of you, he's going to cut to 110 kilos, which he already has. And he's going to face a Devon which weighs 275 pounds, 125 kilos. Now that's not a good thing. Going up against Devon while weighing like 15 kilos, 14 kilos less than him, not a good day, not a good day. But anyways, coming back to that match, I think Jordan's side pressure, I'm not sure if he'll be able to fully hook him or not, but the wrist can stay flat for sure, even if Devon is in a king's move. I think he's going to pin him for sure, once, maybe twice, and then Devon wins 4-2. I'm always saying 4-2, but why 4-2? Did I give prediction for Sandris versus Jordan? Sandris said this, let's say, I'm going with 5-1 or 6-0. So Jordan pins Devon a couple of times. After that, I don't think he... I've never seen him just stand up and press down. He can push sideways, but I've not seen him press down. And that's what's necessary to beat Devon. I don't think he can do that. So 4-2, Devon Laird. Amazing pay-per-view. Umesh, I don't know why not enough people are promoting Umesh Dhruva's event. That's the 4 event, and if we talk about really high level events, that's the second one. This is a high level event and people need to promote it more. Just a $7 pay-per-view. Last time the stream was good, it was cool, but the replays were kind of creepy. I hope he took some feedback and the issue with the replays has been solved. Other than that, the live stream I think is going to be fine. There is going to be a pre-show as well. So there will be some undercard matches. The event is Be Strong Arm Wrestling. So that's where you can find it on YouTube. And the pay-per-view site, as linked in the description, is www.balam.live. I think it's $7 for the event. And I will be doing some live stream commentary as well. So I hope you guys join and let's push this pay-per-view. Great, great initiative. We have King of the Table in Dubai, we have Engin Terzi in Turkey, we have Monster Factory in US, Paul Italia is also trying to do some things. Haven't been able to put up a big, huge super match event, but in Canada, we don't really have anyone. So in Canada, we also need someone to take things, move things forward, and I think Umesh can do that really well, and looks like he's really, really interested into European and especially Bulgarian arm wrestling. Thanks for watching, like the video and subscribe.